Well, thanks to Dave and everybody with Dave Schultz Air Shows for bringing the modern military component to our show. G1D things, but a genuine bought Corsair is here. I'm sure that Bob McClurg, who is has six kills in a Corsair with Pappy Boyington, has been out to check that aircraft out. We have a couple of really beautiful P-51s. Let's see, what else we got? Oh, TBM-wise, you have the Mid-Atlantic Air Museum's new TBM, which will not be flying today because we just stuck it together. We haven't run it yet. And another beautiful TBM here, which will be in the air, plus a great number of transports. We have a B-17 Memphis Belle on the ground. We can take a look through that when the other B-17s flying, plus the Yankee Air Force's C-47. Lots of Russian fighter a little later on today. And of course, very, very rare Spitfire, which you'll see in the air later today as well. So some of the great aircraft that are here. Want you to take your time looking through the encampment, visit our exhibit areas, talk to some of the World War II celebrities we have here as guests, see some of their presentations. And pretty soon it'll be time to start eating food. You can do that in two different locations. One is the one that's right in front of me there, tempting me. The other is out in the flea market area, which is beyond the tea hangers. There are also military exhibits out there as well, the Red Ball military vehicle.
Like a little survey. Nazis intend to declare war on the United States, or whether Hitler will address the Reichstag as rumors. Russia seems to be doing better in the...
Squarely into the center of the picture of world aggression. In his address to the people at 10 o'clock tonight, telling at the war with Japan, his theme will be. And you see flight line right now, propellers starting to spin. What a rare sight that Grumman Hellcat is. That's just something you don't see very often. There's the F4U Corsair, clear prop. That's the R2800, a Pratt & Whitney engine, more than 2,500 horsepower. Coming up. P-47s ended up doing best. They carried as many as 8 50 caliber machine guns, 4 in each wing. You just had to pity the people that were on the receiving end of such a weapon. And those aircraft would be fast and low and unforgiving, just pounding rounds into whatever was on the ground, whatever it was its target. It might be a bridge. It might be troops. It might be a tank. It might be some kind of ammo dump. But when these P-47s hugged the ground and let their cannons fire, it was just a tremendous amount of destruction these aircraft could release.